My name is Roxanne, the Tiny Taster, and today's recipe is a wonderful, fun, Christmas-style rum ball. So now, of course, you could make rum balls or chocolate balls any time of the year, that's not a problem, but keeping with the festive season, I've tweaked it a little bit and of course added a lot more rum to make it extra fun. Now, this is really an easy recipe. It's a no-brainer. You don't have to cook anything and comes together quickly. So I hope you enjoy it. If you do, as always, give it a big fat like. Subscribe to my channel for more videos. It's fun. This actually might be the last video for the year. I'm not sure yet. Let me know if you want more videos this year before the year ends. Leave a comment below. I always want to know what you think. And without further ado, let's get cooking. So for this recipe, you're going to need a nice, lovely Christmas plum cake. This is just a basic cake with those Christmas spices and some chopped almonds and cashews. You're also going to need some chocolate. I've used dark, but you could use any. Some cream, your main ingredient, the rum. And then I've liked to add some tutti frutti and some chopped pistachio for crunch. You could add nuts or any cranberries, anything you like really. In a bowl, you want to melt your chocolate. You could do this over a double boiler, traditionally how they do it, or you could just pop it in the microwave and melt it down completely. To this, you want to add a little bit of whipped cream and then just mix it all together to form a nice thick chocolate ganache. In a mixing bowl, you want to add in your plum cake or your sponge cake. You could even use just a chocolate sponge and then add in some more spices, but a plum cake is ideal. Just crumble it all down into nice fine bits. Do this by hand. You don't need a fork or knife or anything like that. You want to make sure that you form really nice fine crumbs and there are no thick lumps. To this crumbed mixture, you add in all your tutti frutti and your chopped pistachio. If you have any more nuts or berries or fruit that you want to add, you do so at this stage. After that, you're going to add in your main ingredient, which is the rum. You want to maybe measure this out, but you could add as little or as much as you like. There's no right or wrong here. To this, you're going to add about 2 tablespoons of your chocolate ganache. This is just to get the mixture nice and moist. You can also add a little bit of whipped cream if you feel like it needs it, and then just mix it all together. Now this really needs to be done by hand. I added a little bit more cream because I found that the mixture was too dry. If you feel your mixture is dry, you could add more ganache, you could add a little more rum or whipped cream, anything works really. It's just to make sure that it forms together and you mash it down completely, almost to like a dough-like consistency. Once the mixture is nice and wet, you just take a little bit at a time and you form nice round balls. You sort of almost squeeze them in and mash the dough to form little round shapes. You can make as many balls as you like. You can choose the size that you want, big or small, it doesn't really matter. Once you form these all, put them on a plate and put it in the refrigerator for at least half an hour to 40 minutes. Now I would have used the same chocolate ganache, but I actually found it to be a little bit thick and then I ran out of chocolate, so I just melted a fresh batch of milk chocolate, and to that, once it's nice and hot, you dip the ball in and you just coat it and mix it around, and with a fork, very very gently, just try to drip off all the excess chocolate and then place it on a baking sheet and let it cool. You just keep going till all the balls are coated in this lovely chocolate. You want to make sure that when you do this, your ganache or your melted chocolate is nice and warm at least, because if it's cold chocolate, then it will not coat very well. Once they're all coated and you've lined them on a parchment paper, you just pop them right back into the refrigerator and let them cool for another, say, half an hour or 1 hour at least. And this is really it. This is what they look like once they're done. They harden and they smell divine with all that rum and they taste beautiful. You could decorate this with some icing sugar. You could pipe more chocolate on it or put sprinkles or nuts. Anything's possible, really. This is just a simple, basic recipe. And they make for a great gift if you want to give a present to someone that's more handmade and tastes delicious. So I hope you enjoy this. If you do, make sure to give it a big fat like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment, and as always, I will see you soon.